Everybody, it's Tuesday, the 13th of July, and today we're going to read not from the Gospel, but from the book of Exodus, the great book leading the Jews out of slavery. Now we have Moses. Chapter 2, Exodus. A certain man of the house of Levi married a Levite woman who conceived and bore a son, seeing that he was a goodly child. She hid him for 3 months. When she could hide him no longer, she took a papyrus basket, daubed it with bitumen and pitch, putting the child in it, placed it among the seeds on the river bank. His sister stationed herself at a distance to find out what would happen to him. Pharaoh's daughter came down to the river to bathe, while her maids walked along the river bank. Noticing the basket among the reeds, she sent her handmaid to fetch it. Opening, she looked, and lo, there was a baby boy crying. She was moved with pity for him and said, "It is one of the Hebrew children." Then his sister asked Pharaoh's daughter, "Shall I go and call one of the Hebrew women to nurse the child for you?" "Yes, yes, do so," she answered. So the maiden woman went and called the child's own mother. Pharaoh's daughter said to her, "Take this child and nurse it for me, and I will repay you." The woman therefore took the child and nursed it. When the child grew, she brought it to Pharaoh's daughter, who adopted him as her son, and she called him Moses, for she said, "I drew him out of the water." Wow. You gotta like it. They gotta like it. We're maybe all familiar with it. Maybe you saw the movie The Ten Commandments, little cartoons of this, you know, story, little coloring books also. Moses. How God worked it out. Hide the child, and guess the Pharaoh's daughter finds it. And as fate would have it, she gets Moses' mother to nurse it. And she got paid for it. Because you know what happened? They were trying to kill all the male Hebrew boys. So his life was spared. That's what's going on here. Remember that. Kill all the boys of the Hebrew children. So he was saved. He was spared. What a great story. And so God works in our life. Maybe not as fantastic as that. But God arranges people in our life, arranges situations. It may not always make sense. May not agree with it. But God has a plan. If we live by faith and walk by faith, God will get you where he wants you to be. You know, often I look back and say things that I thought were wrong, a door closed, then I realized God got me here. He wanted me here, not someplace else. So maybe the life of, maybe God is playing checkers with you, and he's moving you where he needs to move you. Trust him. Believe God. God's will is always best. God bless you.